guys, welcome back to another YouTube video.
It's been about 2-3 times to make sure all the chances go.
Gonna be doing a how I shop online video. This is episode 6 or 7 of the style series. Now I am excited to film this video because everybody asked me, how do you shop online, what sites to go to, specific stores to look for or to even find. So make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and comment down below. Are you guys excited for another YouTube video? So let's get into the video. All right, so I set you guys up right here so you can semi see my computer. I don't have my ring light. It's currently, you know, down in my basement, but this is a good setup for you guys, right? Right. Okay, so first, what I wanna say is when you shop online, make sure you don't get scammed. Please don't get scammed. You can tell when a site looks somewhat fishy, or it looks sketchy, or it looks like something that, you know, you have never seen before, or the clothes look weird. So make sure you keep an eye on that. And two, when you are shopping, look for the affordable side of the brand and then look for the pricey side of the brand, because you can find one outfit and you can find it on a very expensive high fashion website, and then you can find it maybe on Shein for half that much. So that's another thing to look for. Also, what pieces that you can find online that you cannot find in the store. For example, if you can find a bodysuit in the store at H&M, Forever 21, Zara, do not buy that online. That's just a waste of your time. That's a waste of your money. Maybe if you're looking for a specific shirt texture, rather it's ruffled, it's satin, or it has like a really ruffy material, then that's when you can look online for what that specific item is. Another thing that I want to, you know, point out to you guys is shopping for accessories online and shopping for bags online. Don't get me wrong, you can get some nice jewelry from Amazon. That's what I'm about to show you. You can get some nice necklaces, some rings from Amazon. Anything like that is perfect, especially bags. You know, right now in the stores, you can find a lot of shoulder bags, but what about crossbody bags? What about tote bags? Stuff like that is what, you know, you can find online. So let's go to Amazon right now. And I want to show you guys some specific jewelry that I always purchase, especially on Amazon and shopping online. Now, don't get me wrong, Amazon is a great place to shop for jewelry, and it's a great place to shop for a lot of dupe items. So let's look up gold rings. Now also, when looking for a specific thing, make sure you put that in the search bar, because let's say you just look up gold plain hoops, they're gonna come up gold plain hoops. Let's say you look up gold diamond hoops, then you're gonna get your gold diamond hoops. So you have to be specific when you're looking at something in the search bar. So if you guys can see right here, I'm gonna turn the computer so you guys can see. So these are the rings that I'm talking about. Now, you don't want to get a cheesy ring. You want to get a ring that you know is good quality, regardless if it's cheap or not. Now, I usually get an 8-pack of rings, which was up here, and they're $14.99. And I have one of the rings on right now. This is one of the rings from the set, as you can see right here. Now, this is a 8-piece gold chunky ring for women, obviously, and then you can get your specific size. Now, that's another thing. When you're looking online, make sure you look for the specific measurements and look for the reviews too. Because let's say I scroll down and I see that the ring does not have good reviews, then that's something that I could take in consideration when shopping online or when shopping for that specific item. Now, this has 4.45 out of stars. So obviously that's something that I'm looking into and could take in consideration. Now all the customers have 5+ stars actually, so that's good. And also look at the pricing and the shipment date and everything else when you're shopping online. Now, if you scroll at the bottom, there's a lot of ads that pop up when you're shopping online. There are a lot of recommendations when you're shopping online. Sometimes those can be helpful and sometimes those aren't helpful. But these at the bottom right here is another 8-piece set of rings, and it's a little bit pricier. So that's how they kind of get you, especially when looking for jewelry or bags or anything like that. It can be a little bit more pricier. Now, let's stop with accessories and let's go to bags. Well, I guess it's accessories, right? So I'm looking for a satin black bag. So that's what I'm gonna search in the search bar. Perfect example. I searched up satin black bag and I got jewelry bags. Now that's specifically not what I wanted. I wanted a satin actual purse. And that's when you have to scroll, you have to look, you might have to get more specific in your name or whatever your item that you're looking for. Like, it's popping up to a lot of glittery bags, a lot of clutches, and that's something that I'm not looking for. But this bag popped up, and it's, don't get me wrong, it's not satin, but it's polyester. So, like, you know, it's kind of like that roughy texture-ish, and it's $40. Now, is that worth it? Like, look at it and see, like, is that worth it? If we can go on Shein and maybe we can find something cheaper, that's something also to take into consideration. Thing I wanna get into is being specific when looking for an item. Think about the color, think about the material, think about the texture. Those are the three things you need to look for when searching for an item online. Now, the color, it can range from different shades. It can range from different shades of greens, browns, blues, oranges, whatever it is, the fabric. What is the material? How does it feel? The texture? Is it satin? Is it ruffled? Is it like a fluffy material? Is it furry? That's something you need to look into when looking at material, when looking at clothes, even when looking at shoes. Look at every little bit of clothing. Now, this next section I want to get into is a lot of pricier items or pricier websites. That's personally my favorite, and that you can get nice quality items. Now, we're gonna look at a place called Source Unkown. Now, this place is really good for high fashion items, and they have really good quality. I have ordered plenty of things from them before, and their shipping is great. Don't get me wrong, it's a little bit pricey, but I feel as if you look at different material, if you look at different pieces on certain websites, you can see the uniqueness out of it. You can see how it's different from a regular piece of clothing. You can see how it's made, how the models are wearing it, anything like that. Now, I am looking for a specific type of top. Now, this top, I want to be spring. That's, you know, the mood right now is looking for a spring top. And I want it to be cropped and have a zipper on it. So let's see if we can find it on Source Unkown. Perfect. So we came across actually two different color tops with a zipper on it. The first one is this royal blue one. Oh my God, it is so pretty. It's a cardigan sweater with a zip on it. Now, one thing that I'm looking for when I'm looking for a specific item, I'm looking for the price, I'm looking for the reviews, I'm looking for the texture, I'm looking for how the model is wearing it, how it's made for short people, how it's made for tall people, is it made for my body type, all of that. Is it gonna look good on my texture of my skin, the color of my skin? Now, this is $86. Now, get me wrong, I might can find something more on the affordable side at another site. And sometimes too, when looking for an item or you have an item that's a high price, you can actually copy and paste that specific name into Google and you can find a cheaper alternative of that specific item. So keep that in mind too as well. Now look at the color scheme. What colors does it come in? Look at the back of it. Now I highly will get this, and I'm probably gonna get this because of how it's made, because of the quality, because of the texture, and it's knit. It's something that I can wear multiple times, multiple use. Maybe I can dress it up, dress it down, have it casual. Now, especially when looking for an item, see how many ways you can wear it and how many different styles you can wear it. Like I just said, for this one, maybe I can wear some dress pants like her. I can wear a skirt. I can wear some cargo pants. I can wear it in so many different ways. So you know you're getting your money's worth of whatever you're looking for. This too is something that you can't find in the stores probably, especially in the, maybe in the location that you are in. This right here is something that's unique and something that's worth getting, especially online. Now, also get what you know that you can wear or fit anything else in your closet. Get a shirt that you know that you can match some pants with or some shoes with, or even get a bag that you have an outfit that you haven't worn. Try to stick around pieces that you know that you can incorporate in your outfit as well and how it can elevate your outfit. Two, when shopping online, I'm always looking for a discount, any way to save money. And if you look at the top, the bottom, maybe the corner, some of these websites, you know, will have 50% off, 10% off. Emails, that's another thing. Sometimes the emails can be worth it when signing up. Sometimes they are not. Sometimes they can be scams, and then they'll send you flawless emails and coupons, stuff like that, and that's great. Sometimes you can't do that. So, you know, that depends on what specific store it is or what specific website it is. Now, I want to touch base on a few affordable websites. The first one is SHEIN. I want to talk about SHEIN, Pretty Little Thing, MissGuided. Those are a lot of affordable websites to look on stuff for. What's another one? Princess Polly. Those are affordable websites for the girls. Some expensive websites is, you know, Source Unkown. That's a high, this is what I'm looking at right now. It's a high fashion brand. Sister Seekers is also good. Lowheads is something for streetwear. If you guys want, I will put all the links in the description box below if you guys are interested. What else are some places that I shop at that, you know, have good quality pieces? My Mom Made It, that's really good for bags and accessories. Obviously, like I said before, Amazon is really good for looking for jewelries and bags. SHEIN is really good for looking for tote bags and stuff, and looking at the reviews and looking at the clothes. Now we're gonna shop over at SHEIN so I can show you an example of clothing and the reviews of it and how it's worn on other people and how it can be worn on you. Now, this outfit that I'm wearing is something that I've bought online and I've brought at the store. Now, don't get me wrong, you can find a top online, like I said before, and then match some bottoms. This specific top right here is from SHEIN, and it's a Skims dupe set. So I'm gonna show you guys that specific set and how I end up looking for it, or how I found it. So what I'm gonna look for in the search bar is solid fitted short sleeve tee, and I'm gonna put that specifically in the search bar. As you can see, there is over 200,000 options on SHEIN. Like, that's crazy. And you can look for it. This shirt right here, $7, is the one that I have right now. I got them in all colors. And this is a basic tee that you can wear with anything. You can dress it up, dress it down. I'm telling you, the quality is good. And it's a cheaper alternative for Skims by Kim Kardashian. Don't get me wrong, Skims has some fire things. They're a little bit expensive and they're always sold out in my size. Like, what the heck? But anyways, yeah, so this tee, it comes in 4 different sizes. And you also can look at the size guide of what shirt you want, do your measurements, anything, especially when looking online. Most websites have this. SHEIN is really good. And look at the reviews, look at the images, how does it fit? And as you can see, I don't want to show nobody specifically, but there's over 2,000 images that you can look for to see how it fits on everyone's body shape. And as you can see, I can show this girl, her face isn't in it. It looks really good on her. You can see how fitted it is and the material and all of that. You can see how it's fitted on somebody with, you know, a bigger chest or something like that. Somebody that's, you know, medium size, that's skinny. So that's something when looking for, when, you know, obviously shopping online, the price, only $7. You can get over 15 colors in this specific tee, which is amazing, especially now. Go get your fitted tees from SHEIN, I'm telling you. And sometimes, don't get me wrong, I don't shop at SHEIN that much, and I was just like, should I spend $50 for one fitted tee, or I can spend $50 for 7 fitted tees. So, you know, I had to take that into consideration, obviously, when shopping for that specific thing. And I looked at reviews. I looked at TikTok, see if it was real, if it was legit, if it's good quality. Is the material cheesy? Is it as material? And it's good material. So that's something that I recommend for you girls to buy. And I will put the link in the description box below. Now, we are back on Google. And I want to show you how to look at specific things when shopping online. Now, like I said before, you have to be really, you know, smart about what you say. So let's look up a black ruffled short sleeve top. And we're going to see the options that we can get, the prices, the reviews on everything. All right. So we have looked up ruffled black tops short sleeve. And we have prices ranging from $17 to $250. Now, when I go on the shopping tab on Google, I can look at every different kind of ruffled black top that there is or that I may be able to purchase. I mean, there's stuff from Walmart down to Nordstrom, down to Dillard's, SHEIN, Fashion Nova, Saks Fifth, Ann Taylor, Express, Macy's, Zara, a boutique, anything and everything. I'm telling you, when you look up a specific thing on Google or on any website. Now, I can click on an item that's $69 from Bloomingdale's. Now, this is a ruffled top. It's short sleeve and it's large. Now, I'm looking at how it's made, how's the pullover, the knit on it, the texture, is it spandex, is it nylon? I'm taking all that into consideration when I'm purchasing something online. Now, this is a round neck short sleeve spandex tee, which is good, and it's regular fit. Now, there's some short fit, there's regular fit. There's so many different options when buying a top. It can fit so many different ways on so many different people. So this probably isn't an option for me. Now, let's scroll back up to SHEIN. Now, I can get a ruffled top in a bodysuit texture, and this is a solid fitted tee. So that's another thing when looking for a top or something like that. And looking at the V-line, is it a sweetheart? Is it cropped? Is it V-neck? That's also something too to take into consideration. I hope I helped you guys with tips when shopping online and looking for affordable sites. I put a couple of those in the description box below, as I said multiple times already in this video. Making sure that you buy what you can't get in the stores, buying nice accessories, buying different types of bags, even sometimes designer bags is a good to option. Looking on Grail, that's another alternative for looking at dupe items, or the Real, that's good for looking at bags or designer shoes or whatever. You know, tips on not getting scammed, look at the reviews, look at the price, even look up that specific website on Instagram or on a social media to see if they're actually legit, seeing how many followers they got, how many people, that they even follow, how many posts that they have. That's another thing too, or a tip for you guys as well. Make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe, and comment down below. Are you guys excited for today's video? I'm excited. I'm thankful for everything that you guys do, for commenting, for liking, for watching the video. Thank you guys for 120 subscribers. I am so proud of myself and proud of everybody who's been supporting me and watching me. We will get to 1,000 subscribers by the end of the summer. I bet you that. And time will tell with everything in consistency. Thank you guys for watching. Bye.